Hello students, my name is Shailesh Gavi. I am an assistant professor at AISSMS College, Institute of Information Technology from Department of Artificial Intelligence and Data Science. Today we will discuss about the concepts of object-oriented programming. There are various types of object-oriented programming which is shown in this slide. You can see the class, object, abstraction, data encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, and data hiding. Today, we will explore about the first two headings, that is class and object. Both are interconnected to each other. We can see all the objects, all the concepts are interrelated to each other, and this is nothing but the slide of object-oriented concept. Let us first begin with the differences between procedure-oriented and object-oriented programming. In this diagram, you can see the main function in procedure-oriented programming, and there is no any main function in object-oriented programming. All the objects are interconnected in object-oriented programming, and procedure-oriented programming mostly deals with the functions. Various functions like function 1, function 2, come to function n, respectively present in the procedure-oriented program. What are the various differences in these two languages? In procedure-oriented, there is no security provided. As compared with object-oriented, the security is provided to the data and functions are combined together in object-oriented programming, but that is not available in procedure-oriented. All the features of object-oriented programming that will communicate with each other by message passing. And you can see in this diagram, in procedure-oriented, many functions can access the same data. So the line of code in procedure-oriented program as compared to object-oriented, it is huge. So the line of code in procedure-oriented is very large as compared to object-oriented program. Mostly in procedure-oriented, the top-down approach design concept is available. In object-oriented, bottom-up or top-down, both the concepts it is used for the design. Last difference between these two are, in procedure-oriented, data is exchanged between procedures under control of a main program. When we discuss about the object-oriented programming, objects exchange messages with each other. Let us move on the class. What is meant by class, where it is used? A class is nothing but a user-defined data type, which contains data and member functions to operate on those data members. It is a collection of similar kind of objects. The class is used to implement encapsulation, data abstraction, and data hiding. These are three concepts which is used in object-oriented basic concepts. Classes are just like the blueprint of objects that model real-world things. One most important advantage of using classes is that once you have created a class for a certain type of object, you can reuse the class in any project. So a class is also the implementation of an abstract data type, and it is a class defined by three basic elements, which is a unique class name, data member or its attributes, or the member functions or the methods. Let us see in this diagram. You can see a simple program code as well as the diagram of class. Let us begin with the class diagram. If we compare it with the object is nothing but an instance of a real world entity. which is extracted from the glass. We can see two different blocks related to glass and object. If we create various objects from a single class, my class name is car, and the attributes or the properties or the characteristics of that class are Odoo, Mini and Bitter. These are the various companies and it is nothing but the objects of this particular class. Okay, so this is the general introduction of class and object. Let us move on the left side of this small program code. We can see a class person having various objects it is created. Class name is in this program is person, and name and ID are the objects of this class. We will get the details of this person by using void getDetails, and at the end in main function, which is used in any object-oriented programming, the person has created one object, that is P1. So P1 will directly access the name and ID of that particular person in the given program. Now my next topic is object. An object is a real world entity which has some characteristics called state and some behavior. The state of an object represents that the information held within it. You can see the syntax of the object: class name, object name. You can see the parenthesis at the end of the syntax. See the keywords which is used here: the class and class name. So class name is replaced by a particular class. We can use access specifier, data members and member functions to represent the object. Various objects we are using in this object-oriented programming. Access specifiers can be private, public or protected. Data members are nothing but the variables which is used to give the calculations, mathematical as well as arithmetic calculations, to use the data members to store the values in that. Member functions are nothing but the methods to access data, and at the end the parenthesis with semicomma shows us that class name ends with a semicomma. So any class would be terminated with the semicomma. So this is the general introduction of class and object. We will discuss the data abstraction, data encapsulation, various types of inheritance like single, multiple, multi-level, hierarchical, hybrid inheritance with their examples, advantages. Last but not least, the polymorphism. What we have studied in this lecture, we have got a very basic idea about C++, that is classes and object. When we define a class, you define a blueprint of a data type. And when we discuss about objects, a class provides the blueprints for objects. So basically an object is created from a class. We declare objects of a class with exactly same sort of declaration that we declare variables of basic types. So in objects, there are various variables we use to store the values in that. You can use various references. I use preferably for this particular lecture, Geeks for Geeks, brilliant.org or tutorials point. You can use and access the same from the Google source. Thank you so much for listening this class and object related session. Thank you so much.